10, no help. 6 of clubs. Possible flush. Diamond lady, no help with the straight. Jack's bet.
$5.
I'm out. 5.
5, is it?
Wake up, Perkins, in or not?
Last card, gents.
Hold it!
What the hell are you doing?
They's cheating. Him and the woman. I seen him.
Is that any way to talk about a lady? Luck ran against you, that's all. Why don't you put down the gun and I'll buy you a drink?
After I see the last card you dealt him. See if he fills his flush.
I believe that Jack's wet.
Come on, Steve, it's all right. Get him patched up.
Why'd the doctor leave?
He was called away to deliver a baby.
Get him.
But he said there was nothing he could...
Get him, right now, you hear me?
It's all right, Elizabeth.
A letter.
What?
A letter I told you about.
Your mother's letter?
Yes. Promise me you'll get it to him.
Shh, we'll talk about it tomorrow. What are you doing? Stop it, Lucas. Those are her things.
She's not gonna need them anymore.
Don't you dare open that. Oh.
No.
It's all right, Elizabeth.
Know anybody named Teaspoon Hunter?
No.
Good. So he's gonna make us very rich.
Teaspoon?
Quiet. You're interrupting the flow.
What flow?
Water corpuscles. Percolating up through the ground. Them's what sets the stick a wiggling. Uh-oh. Here we go.
There she is, boys. There's a good stream about 20 foot on.
Careful you don't drown.
It's a lot of digging if you ain't right.
My kinfolk been witching for 6 generations.
Never dug a dry hole.
Sweetwater, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Excuse me. Do you know where I can find the Pony Express station?
It's solid rock, Teaspoon.
Yeah, that's the rock, all right.
I know it's rock. What's it doing here? You said there'd be water.
You gotta get under it.
Under it? You crazy? That rock probably goes clear through to China.
We can't dig a well here.
I knew this was hogwash.
You did, huh? Get out of there. Give me that pit. I don't know how you boys hope to advance yourselves. You let a little rock discourage you. Nothing in this life comes easy. Man's got a claw. Great. Just to keep his head up. It's the trouble with you youngins today. You got too soft. What'd I tell you? Ain't so big. doing the day's work, and we got ourselves a genuine artesian well. First one of those I ever hit.
Well, my, oh my. Can I help you, miss?
I'm looking for Teaspoon Hunter.
You found him. Sorry, we was digging a well. You caught us.
I've come a long way to see you, Mr. Hunter. My name is Elizabeth Kelly.
Yes?
I believe you knew my mother, Beatrice.
Beatrice? Yeah, I knew a Beatrice once.
About 4 years ago, my mother took ill with pneumonia. She recovered, but she never did get her strength back. Not like it was. She passed on in June. I'm sorry to hear that.
Your mother was a wonderful woman.
I think she knew it was coming, but she never complained. I was with her at the end.
Was your pa?
No.
Did you know him, Mr. Spoon?
Yeah, we was partners for a time.
She told me about that, how he cheated you. I know it weighed on her.
What happened between me and Cyrus had nothing to do with your mother.
She gave me this the morning she died. It was real important to her that you get it. I promised to deliver it to you myself.
Newspapers are full of stories about the Pony Express. Everyone thinks you're heroes.
I don't know about that.
Well, you are. Sounds awfully dangerous. Oh, look. He's so cute. What's his name?
Samson.
Come here, Samson. Oh. He sure loves you.
Mike says it's only because he feeds him.
I know, sign. Wait. I had an Indian friend. Wait. It's been a long time since I've done this.
He said there's a wild herd nearby if you'd like to go see him.
Where are your manners, Zach?
The lady has had a long trip. Maybe she'd like to rest.
Pleasure to meet you, Miss Kelly. Name's William Cody.
Hello.
Maybe she don't feel like chasing donkeys around, Ack.
I would like to see some of the country.
I know just the place. Pretty little pond surrounded by willows. Be my honor.
Don't you boys have work to do? I'll take care of Elizabeth.
Church ain't till Sunday, Teaspoon.
Don't sass me, boy.
I was just talking to her. What are you so riled about? What's eating him?
He likes her. You best go easy on him.
Oh.
I was devastated when Cyrus told me you were killed in Texas. That's when I agreed to marry him. Years later, he told me the truth and bragged how he had cheated you out of your rightful share. You placed your trust in him just as I did. How mistaken we both were. I know that money can never repay what you are owed, but doing this has eased the burden on my heart. I pray you accept it.
Accept what?
Well, it seems your mother opened a bank account for me in St. Louis when Cyrus struck it rich. Says here I'm worth over $10,000.
That's wonderful. You're rich.
Well, I can't keep it. This money should be yours.
No, don't worry about that. I was born with a silver spoon in my mouth. Mother saw to it that I had more than enough. But how will the people at the bank know that you're really Teaspoon Hunter?
Well, she took care of that, too. Before I left for Texas, she made me take a keepsake to remember it by. It was one of a pair. And she left the other with a bank manager. When I show him the keepsake, he'll give me the money.
What is it?
Something she knew I'd never part with.
A keepsake from my mother. I'd love to see it.
Elizabeth, would you walk with me? Elizabeth, sometimes things ain't always what they appear. Nature can fool you with mirages and such. Follow me?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this letter explains something like that. Something I never even knew myself.
Knew what?
Elizabeth, your mother and me, we was, well, before she married Cyrus, of course. Oh, dear. We kind of...
We loved each other?
Yeah. She was pretty like an angel. She's beautiful. Soft. Gentle. We loved each other a whole lot. Thing is, she says here that you're the living proof of that.
You mean?
Sorry, but Cyrus ain't your paw.
Don't be sorry.
I'll be along directly.
Get a stack of them in the back here.
Marshal?
All right.
What can I do for you?
Name's Lucas Malone. Expect you've heard of me.
I expect I have. None of it good.
Well, rumors fly, truth walks. Man with your reputation should know that, King.
Yeah. What's on your mind?
Just came by to introduce myself. I'm an ordinary businessman, just like anybody else. Run an honest game. Take what I win and pay what I lose. Trouble comes my way, won't be my doing.
Fair enough, Malone. Play it that way, you won't have any problems with me.
Good. Buy a drink?
Didn't say I'd drink with you.
When are they leaving for St. Louis?
Yeah, Mr. Spoon hadn't decided yet.
Know one thing. He goes, he ain't coming back.
Sure he will.
I don't think so, Lou.
Why not?
Would you if you had $10,000 waiting for you?
That don't mean he's staying there.
He's got Elizabeth to look after now.
And a lady like that ain't gonna be content living in Sweetwater.
But he's got a job here. We need him. He can't just walk out.
What do you think, Emma?
Well, Mr. Spoon's worked hard all his life. Now he has a chance for some comfort. And if he doesn't come back, I'll miss him terrible. But I will understand.
Well, I won't.
Horace, good day.
Spoon. Howdy, miss.
Well, Miss Barnes, good day to you.
Good day, Mr. Hunter.
Is this your daughter?
Yes, this is Clarissa.
Would you like a lollipop?
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Afternoon, Teaspoon.
Marshall, it's my honor to introduce to you Miss Elizabeth Kelly from St. Louis.
Well, my pleasure, Miss Kelly.
Marshall?
Elizabeth is my daughter.
Really?
Yep.
Well, ain't that something? Well, Teaspoon's gonna get a lot more respect around here once folks see you, ma'am.
Well, I'll be. Hanson, come look at here. That's Amanda O'Connor. She's one fine woman if you got the price. This town may not be so bad after all. I think I'm gonna go pay my respects.
You must be mistaken. That's a respectable lady.
My mistake, mister.
You go nearer, and I'll kill you. Understand?
Are you sure you don't want nothing else?
It's perfect. You didn't have to do this.
Well, I'm just trying to make up for all the birthdays and Christmases that I missed.
You truly are a kind man.
You know him?
No, never saw him before.
Yeah!
This country was settled by schemers and fools. Don't let nobody tell you different. Hell, I've been chasing dreams most of my life. There's even one time I was going to get rich. That's what me and your pa, me and Cyrus, was partnered up for. Prospect. I got more gold in my teeth than I ever found in a mine.
I don't think I've ever known anyone like you, Teaspoon.
Well, that's because I broke the mold when I come out.
Shame. The world could use more romantics.
So you think I'm a romantic, huh?
Why else would a man hold on to a keepsake for over 20 years?
It's the only thing of hers I had. Till now.
I'm curious. You never did tell me what it was.
Silver hair comb. I had a pair of them made special for her. Silver come from a strike me and Cyrus worked in the Santa Rita Mountains. She cried when I gave them to her. Then when I went to Texas, she made me take one as a keepsake. I've had it with me ever since.
If you loved her so much, why didn't you ever go back?
I did.
When I got there, I heard they was married. And you was born. Hell, I just turned around and left. Yeah.
Hang on, Cody!
Nice try, Billy. Fool animal never be broke. Maybe I can. It's no use, Hack, I'm telling you. Suit yourself.
You ready?
Thank you.
tired him out. The poor horse was begging for some rest.
He's good, Billy, admit it.
Says you're trying to make him look bad in front of her.
I wasn't doing anything of the kind. It was an accident. I wasn't trying to make fun of you, Ike.
Not so fast, son. You gotta leave your gun at the door. Them's the rules. You wanna go in? Hand it over. Have a good time.
How's it feel to be naked in public? My. I think I've died and gone to heaven. Ike still sore at me?
I know she didn't mean anything. He'll get over it.
I wish he'd hurry. It's bad enough when somebody won't talk to you. With him, it's downright spooky.
Come on, Lou.
Hmm?
Let's get some fresh air.
Excuse me.
Sure.
Is it true you've scalped lots of people?
Just one. Him.
Pleasure of this dance.
You may. Do you want to dance? Sorry.
He doesn't know how to dance.
Well, I can't think of a better time than now to learn. One, two, three, one, two. Uh-huh.
Well, I know when I've been whipped.
Excuse me.
I told you, he hasn't decided yet.
Well, make him decide. Tell him you have to get back to St. Louis. We're wasting time here.
All right. I'll think of something.
We'll wait until your day's ride outside of Sweetwater, and then we'll kill him and get the comb.
Well, smile, darling. That keepsake's gonna make you a rich woman.
I better get back.
Teaspoon.
Half piece of Miss Devlin's plum cake, Sam. Your mouth will thank you.
I need to have a word with you.
You want some?
No, thanks.
What's your trouble?
There's a fella come to town. A gambler by the name of Lucas Malone. You ever heard of him?
No, can't say that I have.
Elizabeth's never mentioned him?
What's on your mind?
Well, I saw him talking outside a few minutes ago.
Well, she's a pretty girl. She attracts all sorts of men. Well,
they appeared mighty friendly, Teaspoon. That ain't none of my business. But you ought to warn her about Malone. He ain't nothing but trouble.
She's still here?
Yeah, he's the one over there talking to Tompkins' wife.
I've done in my whole life.
Mm.
Good night, Mr. Spoon.
Good night, Emma. Could we talk a spell? You too tired?
Of course not.
Good. Let's go to the porch.
Okay.
I ain't too good at this here fathering. I don't pretend to know much about it.
You're doing just fine.
I suppose the last thing you need is some stranger telling you how to live your life.
You're not a stranger. You're my father.
Elizabeth, the greatest treasure a person has is their self-respect. You don't have that, you don't have nothing. You follow me?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Because there ain't no self-respect in hanging out with the likes of Lucas Malone.
Who?
Marshall Kane saw you with him at the dance.
It's possible. I spoke to a lot of men tonight.
The same man you was looking at in town the other day.
What if he was? I don't know what you're driving at.
I ain't judging you, Elizabeth. I got no right to do that, but there's something wrong you ain't telling me.
All right. I'm sorry. You're right. I do know Malone. I lied because I was scared. I was afraid if I told you the truth, you'd turn me away.
I'd never do that. What happened?
Daddy. I mean, Cyrus. Used to come into my room at night. When my mother was sleeping. He'd do things to me. I tried to make him stop, but he was so much stronger than I was. I wanted to tell my mother the truth, but I felt ashamed. I felt dirty. I thought she wouldn't even believe me, so I ran away.
How'd you get tied in with Malone?
I was 16. He took me in. He fed me. He bought me pretty clothes.
You mean he kept you?
Yes. I'm not proud of it, but I had nowhere else to turn. You sure weren't there.
How could I be?
What do you know about my life? What I went through? How I had to live? You're a man, just like all the others. You use a woman and then you judge her by your own rules.
Elizabeth, that's... Just calm down.
All I want now is to settle someplace and start a new life. I'll pack in the morning.
No, you won't. Beatrice was and I was fools to part in the first place, and you suffered for it. Now, you're here with me, and it's going to stay that way. That's the way it's going to be, just like she wanted it.
Ah!
Hey, Emma. Whew. I'm starved.
I'll fix you some hotcakes.
Where's Teaspoon?
Delivering supplies at the next station. What's the matter?
I don't understand this letter he wrote. It says he doesn't want the money. He's giving it to me, all of it. We're leaving for St. Louis tomorrow.
That sounds like Mr. Spoon. What don't you understand?
He couldn't mean it. Nobody gives away $10,000. Nobody. Why would he do a thing like that?
You're his daughter. That's all he needs to know.
Teaspoon's not like anyone I've ever known. It's confusing me. Can I borrow your wagon? I need to get off by myself to think.
Absolutely. I see it's hitched up.
What's wrong?
Nothing. I've got great news, Lucas.
Well, you shouldn't have come here. Somebody might have seen you.
Don't worry. I was careful.
What is it?
That fool is going to give me the money. All of it. Look at this letter he wrote. Do you realize how easy that makes it? All we have to do is let Teaspoon go to the bank himself. He gets the money, gives it to me. I give it to you.
You believe this? He'll never do it. Nobody gives up a fortune.
He will. I know him. That's the kind of man he is.
Well, then, you're a bigger fool than he is.
Listen to me, Lucas. I know men. It's my business. I know how they act. Teaspoon will give me the money. You don't have to kill him.
You going soft, Amanda? You all of a sudden developing a conscience? I'd say it's a little late for salvation.
Call it what you want. He's a good man. Go ahead and rob him. I just don't want him killed.
Well, I ain't leaving him to bring the law down on me, so.
Then I'll give you my share.
What are you up to? That old fool told you something, didn't he?
No.
There's more money, and you're holding out on me.
I'll kill you for that.
Now, you ain't playing with some tinhorn gambler here. You're working for me. You could do exactly like I planned. Well, you ain't gonna live to see that precious daddy of yours. You understand?
Yes.
What are you doing?
Nothing, Emma. I was just tidying up.
Don't lie to me. I saw you.
It's not what you think.
What kind of person are you? Why would you do this to Mr. Spoon? Why would you want to hurt him that way?
I'm not trying to hurt him. I'm trying to save him.
Save me from what?
Elizabeth was already ill by the time she reached the hotel. She was too sick to go on, but she wouldn't listen. She was set on finding you. It's a miracle she made it to Fort Kearney. Her room was next to mine. I took to caring for her. We used to spend hours talking. That's how I knew about Cyrus. Elizabeth and I led the same kind of life. I guess that's why I took to her. I never knew my own father, but the men my mother lived with weren't much different than Cyrus. I've told you a lot of lies, Teaspoon. But I'm not lying about this. Elizabeth was a fine woman. And I was proud to be her friend. I tried the best I could to help her. I'm so sorry.
Are you going to turn Amanda over to the marshal?
I don't bear no grudge.
Even though she tried to cheat you?
And they would have killed you, too.
That's right. She could have let them. Instead, she tried to steal the comb so they wouldn't. No, it don't make sense, but I've grown fond of Amanda. Facts don't change that. She cared for Elizabeth, and then she prayed over her. I feel as I owe her. Only score I got to settle is with Malone.
I don't know why we just can't take on Malone directly.
Because he ain't stupid, because he's got two hired guns in the law on his side, and because you'd be either dead or in jail. We've got to force his hand, make him come to us so as we can deal with
him. What's your plan?
Well, the only way I know to get a snake out of his hole, give him what he wants.
Jack's over nine.
Congratulations.
It's about damn time.
You looking for somebody?
Ain't looking no more, Malone.
What can I do for you?
I come to play.
You got a stake, old man? Get around on me, boy. What's your pleasure?
Five-card draw, one hand.
Oh, all or nothing. I like your style.
You win, you get to comb the money. No trouble from me.
If I don't?
You ride out of Sweetwater. Either way, Amanda's out of it.
Playing for the lady's honor. Well, now, appears I owe you an apology, darling. But
that's what the man wants. Let's do it.
She's got the best hands in the territory. Aces over tens.
Straight.
Must be beginner's luck.
I know.
Deal's deal. We best be packing up.
I look forward to seeing you again.
Real soon.
Drinks on me.
Headed back to Emma's, like you said.
Good. Keep an eye on Amanda.
I'm going with you.
No, you ain't.
Teaspoon, you're not my daddy. I wish you were, but you're not. Now, I've got my own score to settle with Malone. I'll get the buckboard.
I don't know, Teaspoon. You sure you two ain't related?
Gonna run all night. Gonna run all day. I bet my mother in the bucktail hang. Somebody bet on the bay. I know a good one. I dream of Jeannie with a light brown hair. Get out of the way, all of you.
I don't talk to dead men. You. I'm gonna make you pay for this. You can bet on it. Get the comb.
I can make him suffer, I can make it quick. Your call.
No, it ain't!
Just toss it aside nice and easy.
Wouldn't shoot me in the back, would you?
I'm tempted. But I wouldn't want you to miss out on 10 years of busting rock.
Well, I appreciate your kindness.
I was hoping you wouldn't disappoint me.
I'll write to you when I get to St. Louis.
And you better write back.
Now, I ain't too good a letter writer. Damn spelling gets me.
Well, then you're just going to have to learn.
Loading up, folks.
Thank you.
You take care now.
I want all you boys to look after yourselves now. Save me a dance.
I want you to take this with you.
I can't.
I'll be writing the bank manager in St. Louis to give you the money.
No, it's not right. I won't.
I don't want no argument. My mind is set. That money's there to help somebody. Ain't gonna do me no good. I got everything I need right here. If you take it to begin a fresh life, I'd consider it well spent.
I'll take it. But only if we're partners.
Partners? Partners in what?
I've always wanted to own a fancy saloon. Something with class. $10,000 should buy us a pretty nice place. It'll be an even split.
Think of that, boys.
Well, I never could say no to a good saloon or a pretty lady.
I'll write you a teaspoon. Something to remember me by.
Get up here!